Gritty Urban Saga. So who is Howard the Duck? This is a question a lot of people are obviously going to be asking, so I figured I should make a video to help people with that, because there's a lot of wacky information to sift through to get to the bottom of that. So let's get right into it. Now, he was first introduced in a series of comics called Adventure into Fear. It was actually issue 19 of that in December 1973. And he was originally just supposed to be a parody character, just a one-off. They were going to throw him away. But he gained so much popularity that he became one of Marvel's biggest 1970s comic book characters. So it's cool to see that he went from somebody that was just or a character that was going to be thrown away, and just based off of fan feedback, he became one of the biggest. He was created by a guy named Steve Gerber and an artist named Val Merrick. And the overall idea of him was supposed to be a very cynical, cigar-smoking, just basically had a bad view of the world. But he went on to have his own comic book series in 1976, and he got his own movie, a big screen movie in 1986, produced by George Lucas. It was produced by a few other people, but yes, George Lucas was a co-producer on this movie. It was also pretty much a box office bomb. It only made about $900,000 more than they spent to make it, and it's widely seen and considered as one of the worst movies ever. I like the movie, so to each his own. One of the reasons behind that could possibly be that the lady, Gloria Katz, who was in charge of adapting the whole idea of Howard the Duck to the screen, she went basically around what the creators had in mind for Howard the Duck and said, hey, he's a duck from space. It shouldn't be about all that. It shouldn't be about his idea about the world. So she toned down all the existentialism, and the creators weren't too happy about that. But, you know, it turned out the way it did. He is a master of a thing called quack foo. It sounds really corny, but it's helped him to defeat much larger opponents. He has slight mystical talent that was recognized by Stephen Strange or Doctor Strange. And he also has his own Iron Duck suit. It was created by a guy named Claude Starkowski, which is obviously a play off of Tony Stark. He basically has been fighting alongside or with a lot of major characters. Even in issue number one, he is fighting alongside Spider-Man. So he's not just, you know, some B-rated comic book character. He's been with the best of them, fought with the rest of them. Now, he's been in video games, newspaper comic strips. He's been in Hulk Agents of Smash, and he's also been in an even more recent project that I'm not going to spoil if people haven't seen it yet, but you definitely know what I'm talking about, most likely, if you're clicking on this video. So yeah, hopefully we'll see a lot more of him in the future. I really did enjoy the 1986 movie, and I just like his overall attitude towards life in the comic books and things like that. So if this helped you out to know who he is a little bit better, definitely drop me a like. And also, if you're looking forward to more content like this in the future about comic book characters or movie characters, definitely drop a subscribe here and you'll be getting an email whenever I put up a video. So thanks for stopping by, guys. Gritty Urban Saga.